human digestive system. It consists of the alimentary canal and its associated glands. Here the alimentary canal is shown. Alimentary canal is the long tube running from mouth to anus. The various organs of human digestive system are mouth, oesophagus, through which the food passes into the stomach. Stomach, which is a broad bag-like structure. Small intestine, which is a very long narrow tube-like structure. From stomach, the food comes into the small intestine. Large intestine. From small intestine, the undigested part of the food passes into the large intestine. Then rectum, which is a part of the large intestine. And then anus. The glands, which are associated with the digestive system, are salivary gland. There are three pairs of salivary gland in our mouth. Liver. It is the largest gland. It is in the upper part of our abdomen on the right side. Pancreas. It is a yellowish gland and is situated just below the stomach. Salivary glands are located in our mouth and secrete saliva. The secretions of all the glands are necessary for digestion. So, liver is the largest gland, which is situated on the right side of the upper abdomen. It is reddish brown in color. It secretes bile. Pancreas is cream colored or yellowish and secrete different enzymes which are necessary for digestion. The digestion of food starts in our mouth. The mouth or buccal cavity contains salivary glands, tongue and teeth. The salivary glands secrete a liquid called saliva, which helps to digest the starch present in the food. Oesophagus is a pipe-like structure which connects the mouth to stomach. The food moves down through it by peristalsis. During peristalsis, the walls of oesophagus start alternative contraction and expansion, producing a wave-like movement, and so the food moves downwards. You can compare it with the ejection of toothpaste from the tube. Now observe the diagram. Now we will see the peristalsis in oesophagus. Stomach is a bag-like structure, which is present on the left side of the abdomen. In the alimentary canal, it is the widest part. The food which comes through the oesophagus is further digested here. Mainly proteins are digested in the stomach. For about 3 hours, the food is churned in the stomach. During this time, the food is broken down and is converted to a semi-solid paste. The inner lining of the stomach secretes mucus, digestive juices, and hydrochloric acid. Mucus protects the inner lining of the stomach from the action of its own secreted hydrochloric acid. Digestive juices digest specially the proteins present in the food, and so some amount of proteins are broken down into simpler substances. Hydrochloric acid kills the microorganisms present in the food and also makes the food acidic, which is necessary for the digestion in the stomach. Small intestine is a long tube of about 7.5 meters long. It is so named because it is a very narrow tube. It is a very coiled structure, and the food passes from stomach to small intestine. Small intestine is the site of complete digestion, and the digested food are absorbed here. Small intestine receives secretions from liver, pancreas, and of its own inner wall. These secretions are necessary for complete digestion of the partially digested food, which comes from the stomach. Liver secretes a liquid called bile. In the digestion of fat, bile plays an important role. It converts the fat into tiny droplets, and so the fat digestion becomes easy. Bile is stored temporarily in the gallbladder, which is a sac-like structure. Pancreas secretes pancreatic juice, which breaks down fats, proteins, and carbohydrates. The digested food is then absorbed in the wall of small intestine and then passes into the blood vessels present in the wall of small intestine. There are millions of finger-like projections in the inner surface of small intestine. These are called villi. The villi have network of small blood vessels. The main function of villi is the absorption of digested food. Due to presence of villi, the inner surface of small intestine becomes increased and rapid absorption takes place. Blood carries the absorbed food matters in the cells of all parts of the body. In those cells, the simple foods are used for energy, growth and repair. This is the assimilation. In the cell, the glucose is broken down with the help of oxygen, and then carbon dioxide and water are released. During this time, energy is also released. Fatty acids, glycerol and amino acids are mainly required for growth and repair. The undigested parts of food cannot be absorbed and pass into the large intestine. Large intestine is about 1.5 meters long. It is so named because it is a wide tube. Large intestine absorbs the water from the undigested food material. Due to absorption of water, the undigested food material becomes semi-solid and is stored in the rectum, which is the last part of large intestine, for some time. This semi-solid waste is passed out from our body through the anus. This is digestion.